মাই নেম ইজ ইউক্তা অ্যান্ড আপনি দেখছেন এখন নিউজ টুডে।
Narayana Health is taking this initiative to throw light on two subjects today. One, the role of AI in digestive care, gastroenterology. And the second, the importance of organ donation. How, as a society, we can raise awareness so that this does not become a one-off case, it becomes a regular practice. On stage today, starting from my right, we've got Dr. Rahul Roy, GI and liver transplant surgeon, Dr. Sandeep Pal, gastroenterologist, Dr. Bohidar, also gastroenterologist, and Dr. Abhijit CP, director, Rabindranath Tagore Hospital.
Today we have gathered here for this press conference. So we shall discuss three topics here. So the first is AI, then the application of AI in gastroenterology. Next, Dr. Rahul Roy will speak on liver transplantation, he will speak on the deceased donor liver transplantation, and Bohidar sir will speak on live deleted liver transplant. So let me start first with AI in gastroenterology. So you must be seeing now in WhatsApp also, when you open your WhatsApp, the AI has come. So everywhere, if you Google something, AI is there. So if you write something in the Google, if you want to search, first AI will give one result. Then you can scroll down and you can see the other searches. So AI is becoming slowly, it is becoming indispensable in our day-to-day life, as well as the applications are coming in gastroenterology. Now, this is not new. This AI thing is going on for decades, say almost one or two decades it has been there. But since last 3-4 years, it has come rapidly. It has come almost to the practice. So right now, the status of our state, we are not applying this technology in our day-to-day practice. But yes, for research purpose and to do it on patients, we have done a few cases. So what I can tell you about this technology is artificial intelligence is all about computer learning. So first, we have to feed the computers. Let me give you an example. Suppose, as you know, there is a large intestine, and in the large intestine, there are polyps or tumors that happen, or in the biliary tract, in the CBD, pictonally, okay, tumor hoy. So what happens now? How do you know when we do endoscopy? How do you know when you see the polyp, whether it is a malignant polyp or it is a benign polyp, or if we are missing any polyp? Because the colon is a long structure, around 1.5 meter long, and there are folds in the colon. So when you go with the scope, sometimes if there is a polyp behind the fold, we can miss it. And in standard textbooks, the miss rate of polyp is from 20 to 30% when we do first time colonoscopy. So what is done in this technology is we feed the machine with images. Millions of images are being fed to the machine. Like this is a malignant image, this is a benign image, and this is how a polyp looks. It's fed into the machine from our, what we do procedures normally without AI, we have all record our procedures, all the pictures are recorded into our system. So these pictures we are feeding to the machine. So next time when we apply this software into the colon, the software tells us, here there is a polyp. So it shows, a rectangle comes and it shows us that there is a polyp. So we can go back if we have missed that and we can detect. So it helps in improving the detection rate of polyps. And it is it has come first in the Western countries because they are more predisposed to colonic cancer. But we are also not far behind. In India also, colon cancers are there. A lot of colon cancers are there, we see in our regular practice.
Good afternoon, everyone. I speak about disease donor transplant. So who is a disease donor? Disease donor is a person whose heart, as the circulation is intact, the blood supply to all organs are intact. But there is head injury, brain injury, and as a result of which the patient is in a comatose state, and for them a meaningful recovery is not possible. So in such cases, if their family members agree, gives consent to donate the organs, those organs can be retrieved and can be transplanted into other patients who need a transplant for their healthy life. So from one disease donor, two kidneys can be given, lung can be transplanted, heart can be transplanted, liver we can split it to two, and we can give one small part to a child and the bigger one to an adult, and also cornea can be donated. So with disease donation, one person can save 6 to 7 lives. So where lies the problem is the disease donor rates. It is very low, particularly in the eastern region of the country, and as a result of which a lot of people are dying every day waiting for a transplant to happen.
Good afternoon, everybody. Today we are assembled here regarding the conference that we are holding. The two major topics, as you said, is artificial intelligence and liver transplantation. We want to make some awareness amongst the general population. And what we have done today, tomorrow and day after tomorrow, is that the doctors who will be practicing gastroenterology, or they will be giving gastroenterological service to the people, if they are educated enough about these two things, then our job will be better done. And in one complete year, it will be completely the same organ again. So the person who is donating, maybe after a month or so, he will be able to walk around, his normal activity he can resume, and in roughly 1 year's time, the liver will also be complete. So that's very important. People are shy of giving, or they're apprehensive of giving, donating a part of liver. So it should be clearly passed on to the general public.
Very nicely elaborated on what this conference is about and what we are planning to do over the next 2 days. Like Dr. Sandeepal pointed out, in the last 3 to 4 years, the advancement of AI in healthcare has been very rapid. And as a hospital, we have adopted AI in a few areas like radiology and imaging, neuro intervention, and the initial results have been fantastic. It improves accuracy, it improves throughput, it's way faster than what humans can do. So this adoption, we have to increase awareness, and we have to ensure that we adopt it with enough safety protocols. So over the next 2 days, we will do our best to spread this awareness. If there are any questions, we can
मेरा नाम डॉक्टर संदीप पाल है. मैं कंसल्टेंट गैस्ट्रोएंटरोलॉजिस्ट हूँ नारायणा आर एन टैगोर हॉस्पिटल में. सो आज हम प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस कर रहे हैं जो नया टेक्नोलॉजी है आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, और आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस का जो एप्लीकेशन है गैस्ट्रोएंटरोलॉजी में उसके बारे में. सो ये एक बिल्कुल नया टेक्नोलॉजी है जो अभी हम लोग अभी रिसर्च विंग में ही है, अभी रोज़मर्रा के यूज़ के लिए नहीं है, हम लोग नहीं कर रहे हैं ऐसा मशीन अभी तक पब्लिक यूज़ के लिए नहीं है. लेकिन ये नया रिसर्च है जो अभी आ रहा है, नेक्स्ट 2-3 साल में ये आ जाएगा पेशेंट्स के यूज़ के लिए भी. तो इसमें क्या होता है, मशीन लर्निंग. तो हम लोग जो कंप्यूटर होता है, कंप्यूटर को हम लोग फीड करते हैं उसको. जैसे कि मैं एग्जांपल देके बोलना चाहता हूँ, अगर एक पॉलिप है कि पॉलिप कैसा दिखता है, कैंसरस पॉलिप कैसा दिखता है, बिनाइन पॉलिप कैसा दिखता है, ये हम लोग मशीन को मिलियंस ऑफ इमेजेस फीड करते हैं. फिर मशीन का एक मेमोरी बढ़ जाता है कि ये कैंसर पॉलिप ऐसा दिखता है, नॉन कैंसर पॉलिप ऐसा दिखता है. फिर वो टेक्नोलॉजी जब हम पेशेंट में यूज़ करते हैं तो मशीन हमें आसानी से बता सकता है कि ये जो पॉलिप आप देख रहे हैं ये ख़राब पॉलिप होने का चांस है. तो हम उसका ट्रीटमेंट जल्द से जल्द कर सकते हैं, और ये एक हेल्प है. और दूसरा जो यूज़ उसका है कि ये कई बार पॉलिप डिटेक्शन में भी हेल्प करता है. जैसे कई बार हमें मिस हो जाता है पॉलिप, क्योंकि कोलोन बहुत लंबा 1.5 मीटर है, उसमें फोल्ड्स होते हैं, फोल्ड्स के पीछे अगर पॉलिप रहे तो दिखता नहीं है. तो अगर हम ये टेक्नोलॉजी यूज़ करते हैं तो मशीन हमें बता देता है कि उस जगह पे पॉलिप है, इस जगह पे पॉलिप है, तो डिटेक्शन रेट भी इंक्रीज हो जाता है.
गुड आफ्टरनून, आई एम डॉक्टर राहुल, आई एम कंसल्टेंट इन लिवर ट्रांसप्लांट एट नारायणा रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर हॉस्पिटल. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्पीक यू अबाउट लिविंग डोनर्स who can donate their organs, particularly liver. So as you all know, liver is a single organ, unlike kidney. But in liver, we can split into two halves, right and left, and one part can be used to cure liver diseases. So who can be a liver? Anybody in the family whose blood group matches with the patient and is between 18 to 50 years of age can donate part of his liver.
हम कॉन्फ्रेंस कर रहे हैं कल परसों हमारा इधर एक कॉन्फ्रेंस हो रहा है। ये कॉन्फ्रेंस में हम इंडिया के बहुत सारे डॉक्टर्स आ रहे हैं, कुछ तो आ रहे हैं पार्टिसिपेट करने के लिए डिस्कशन में, और कुछ सीखने के लिए भी आ रहे हैं। हमारे स्टेट से भी बहुत सारे डॉक्टर आ रहे हैं। ये सब मोस्टली फिजिशियंस हैं, मेडिसिन स्पेशलिस्ट और गैस्ट्रोएंटरोलॉजिस्ट हैं। तो हमारा दो टॉपिक हमने लिए हैं, आर्टिफिशियल इंसुलिन एंड लीवर ट्रांसप्लांट। ये दोनों के बारे में हम लोगों को जागरूकता बढ़ाना है। तो हम तो आम आदमी को जाके बुझाने के बजाय हम ये डॉक्टर लोगों को समझाएं, ये इंटर्न और बहुत सारे लोगों को समझाएंगे और समाज में इसका जागरूकता बढ़ेगा। साइंटिफिक बेसिस में क्या हो रहा है, आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस कितना ट्रांसप्लांट होता है, क्या क्या फैसिलिटीज है, शॉर्ट कमिंग्स क्या है, ये सब के बारे में विस्तृत डिस्कशन होगा। नरेंद्र प्रसाद बोईदार, आर एन टेगोर में गैस्ट्रोएंटरोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट हेड।